There's a lot to say, and I have all these ideas going in my mind right now, like from where should I begin? So I truly don't have any script going on, any outline, any nothing as such. All that I have is my heart and my mind, and that's what I'm gonna redeem out here on this great opportunity that I've got. To begin with, I think I'll start from the extreme beginning of my life, a journey. A wonderful journey with great, great highs and lows that have happened, that I've been through. Imagine a little girl who belongs to a very, very happy family, a very happy Gujarati family is what I can say, who all go around to meet relatives and meet people and having fun with in a very positive environment growing up to be 13 and losing her mother to ovarian cancer. 8 months, those 8 months of my life were terrible. Every time I think about it, it makes me cry because that just came out of nowhere to me. And I hope that doesn't happen to any one of you out here or anyone out there, but it was really difficult for a 13-year-old kid to handle all of that stress. A girl who did not know what womanhood was about, to be very specific, a girl who did not know what menstrual cycle was all about. How different was she from her counterpart from the other gender? And all that she knew since childhood was that she was not supposed to wear short clothes because she's a girl. That's all had her mother and her father and her family, which was a traditional family, had taught her. And that's all she knew. Yes, I had a younger brother, a year younger to me. Speaking about this ahead, I was thrown to play a role of the woman of my family at 13 years of age. Imagine. I want you all to connect with me because that is when you will relate and understand what all I've been through and why am I speaking about it. 13-year-old kid, sixth or seventh standard. Her mother passed away and is not forced, but she had a responsibility to cook food for her family. And this was what her day looked like. 4 a.m., there were two options. Either you get up, cook food for yourself and your brother, which is the school tiffin, or else you wake up an hour and a half later and starve for 6 hours, or rely on someone else's tiffins, your friend's tiffins. 6 to 12, studying, hungry or with food, that's the option, that's the thing with you. 1 to 2, 9th and 10th standard are really, really important. They are the basic things, basic years of your life, of your education, of your academics. And 9th and 10th, I used to have coaching classes. I've been born and brought up in Mumbai. And these are the two really important years of my life, of any child's life. And I had to go to coaching classes to get myself educated, knowledged. And yeah, of course, study, clear exams. 6 to 7 hours are what the classes take place there. And again, 1 to 9 or 1 to 8, I used to be in classes. Again, no tiffin, nothing, starving. Or else the day prior what you've cooked, you take that, but there's no option of cooking food again, or else you stay back home, bunk your class, and do something about food and just miss out on your studies. 9 to 11, I used to cook food for my family, a 13-year-old girl who used to cook food for her family, which includes 15 chapatis, one sabzi, roti, and dal. And yeah, 15 chapatis, dal, rice, and sabzi, which was mandatory. I belong to a very middle-class family, and yes, you guys would have a doubt that why not a maid if that was a real struggle, because I don't know, I'm a strong believer of destiny and hard work, which goes hand in hand, and destiny wasn't with us. We were not very financially strong, so we could not afford a maid, and I used to do that. Besides, it's not just about cooking food and stuff, it's about adopting your mind, being precautious, and assuming yourself as a woman, which is nearly impossible for a 13-year-old child, but it was difficult. I went through that phase. I am very proud to say that I overcome that phase with the support of my father and my brother. Coming up next, you see this girl on right and the other one on left. The left one was me when I was 16 or around 17. Some of you, like, in fact, I think I have come across these comments that you're ugly. I was ugly. I was believed to be ugly. I was fat. I was unconventional, not accepted as a beautiful face. I was 19 when I dreamed of being crowned as Miss India, and I would not share that with anyone because I was scared of what would people think about me. Once this happened, that one of my friends, they saw a pageant app on my phone accidentally, and he asked me, like, are you interested in pageants? Do you want to be Miss India? And I said, yes, that is the reason I have this app. And he started laughing. He rolled on the floor and laughed for like 10 minutes. He went to 5 different people, told them, like, guys, imagine what this Nehal wants to be. She wants to be a Miss India. I mean, and they all started laughing. And these are the embarrassing moments that I faced, but they never stopped me from being what I was. I've always been very confident, very, very confident. I don't know the reason behind it. I think it's because my father has always shown that trust on my abilities. My father has always shown that I am an intelligent kid and I can do whatever I want to do. Because I have been brought up by a man, by a single father, and I've been taught to be fearless, to be independent, and to be strong. I wouldn't say that losing a mother was a very fortunate incident, but somewhere I believe everything happens for a reason. And yes, this happened for good, because if I were a kid under my mother's pallu, I would have been a woman who would have been shy, who would have been very fearful, who wouldn't have had her voice and a chance to make any choices that what she wants to do in her life. But I think that incident has had a positive impact on my life as well. So this difference that you see is, I'm sure a few of you might be knowing if you followed my journey. This is when I lost 20 kilos in 3 months back in 2016. I tried for Miss India in 2015, 16, 17. And finally, in 2018, I could make it. The reason why I'm sharing this with you all is because I want you all to believe in yourself. That no matter where you stand today, if you think about achieving something, you can do it if you believe that there is a possibility of that. In fact, you got that thought in your mind because you thought that was possible. And that's what I did. If you look at the one on the left side, that was the girl who had this thought on her mind that she could be Miss India. She could represent her country in a beauty pageant, a very unconventional beauty. Second thing I want to really focus on and put light on is self-love. This transformation went viral, and women from all over the country started approaching me to train them. And a small choice of exploring my abilities, I used that as I converted that into a profession. I got myself certified as a fitness trainer, and I started helping people to transform, to evolve. Now, I often come across questions where people ask me, you advocate self-love, fine. You are a fitness consultant. How does these two go along? Like, if you are advocating self-love, you should just let people be what they are. You must not encourage or influence them to be something, to achieve something, their body goals. No, that's not how it works. But I say self-love is when you love yourself, is when you are contented in the way you are, but you want to see what all you can achieve or explore. Exploring yourself is a part of self-love. Let's say, for example, if I am looking towards myself into a mirror, I am happy. I am happy. And I'm contented and I'm grateful that what all I have. But let's do what's next? Okay, I'm happy. What's next? Let's do something. Let's explore what all I can do next. And that's what I did. I was very confident even with that body. I used to host events. I used to exceed in doing that. I was a performer on stage and no one could pinpoint me that, oh, she's fat, she can't do it and still she's here. No. I was always confident. I always loved myself. The only reason behind this transformation was because I wanted to explore what else can I do. And age, your financial situation, and people around you, and anything else doesn't matter. Doesn't matter at all. And I think it's a very, very underrated word, self-love. Because once you realize the real power of it, you know, I've been known for my hard work. I have been known for my confidence. I've been known for my communication skills or whatever. Every person has their own perspective. But I think what best defines me is that I believed in myself and that I loved myself. There's a big, big misconception about self-love. People misunderstand that with being selfish. In fact, if we think about self-love, the words that come in our mind is selfish, is self-obsessed, mean, that person is mean, all those negative words, but it is a big time misconception. Can we all do this exercise? Can we all do this exercise? Can we all do this exercise? Yeah. I'll just explain. Take a deep breath, open your arms and say, I am the best. Can we do this? I am the best. I love myself. I love myself. What does that make you feel? Can anybody tell me? Can someone genuinely do that and tell me what does that make you feel? Yes, please. I cannot hear you, sorry. Okay, let me say. I think for me, it makes me feel happy. And when you're happy, you feel grateful. And when you're grateful and contented, fully contented, that is when you will go and help others and try to grow more. Grow more is one part and helping others is one part. This is a very, very famous proverb that goes that selfless is not selfish, and help yourself first and then help others. And that is what I strongly believe in. People, some of them, they still feel that self-love is not an advocacy, but it is. It is, because once people start realizing the importance of loving yourself first and then going to help others, which is what I did, I transformed lives today. People from Muscat, people from UK, they approach me to train them online. And there's no one else who feels happier than those clients. Because they see themselves as something new. And that is what I have been advocating, self-love. And that's what my life is all about. Thank you. Thank you so much.